It's Fish Talk with Leo. That's right, it's me, Leo, interviewing the experts and taking you behind the scenes of all the amazing work that's happening at Parks Canada.
Shh, we don't want to disturb the babies. This is one of the most special places in the water world, the Eel Grass Meadow. It's where many of us fishes come to have our babies. It's such a beautiful thing, but it's shocking to know the eelgrass meadows are disappearing faster than the rainforest. Luckily, Jen and her team from Parks Canada are monitoring the meadows, and what's curious is they're doing it from the sky with a bird's eye view. Hey Jen, by chance, are you near an eelgrass meadow?
Yeah, so here we are in Grace Bay in Pacific Rim National Park. And behind us, although the water is completely covering it right now, is a whole mass of eelgrass meadow. Here I have some eelgrass right here, a couple shoots. Really cool thing about eelgrass, as you can see, is it actually has roots. So this one, these roots are under the sediment there. And so they'll actually hold that muddy sediment in place and make all the currents. They actually slow down the currents and collect the sediment, so it makes a really good home for all those fish.
Well, I can't imagine anything more important than a fish nursery.
Yeah, this is a really important to know all about our eelgrass meadows because it's where a lot of our fish and crabs start out their life. So really important in supporting all of our marine fish.
How do you monitor what's happening in the nursery? I suspect this is where your bird technology comes in. Ha! I'm just being clever. I know, it's actually a drone. But listen up, team. Unless you're out with Jen on a science mission with permission from Parks Canada, flying a drone in a national park is a big fish head's no-no. You were saying, Jen?
We can take our drones and we fly above the eelgrass meadow and take pictures of the eelgrass at low tide when it's exposed to the air.
Clever! Checking out the eelgrass meadow from the sky?
Just like how a bird might see it.
Kind of like being like a bird. Propellers. We've got our control panel. Two antennas that we're going to make sure up. Android that will clip in so we can see where we're flying. And then we'll put this battery in. So the propellers will carry it straight up. And it flies much like a helicopter. We can get images or photos of every piece of the eelgrass, and then afterwards we put it into the computer, and then lickety-split, it's a beautiful one picture altogether.
Incredible! Looks like a fun way to get another look at the world.
So this may look like a toy that anybody can fly, but you actually need a license to fly this, just like you do with a car.
So what have you learned from monitoring the eelgrass?
Well, some of the things that we have learned is sometimes people come out onto these waters and they boat around and they have the props on their boats. And if they go into shallow areas where there's eelgrass, they can actually cut up the eelgrass. And sometimes we can see boat scarring through the eelgrass meadow where they've actually torn up sections of the eelgrass. So something we can do when we notice that is we can go and say, okay, this isn't a good place for boaters to drive, and we can put up places, mooring buoys, and also tell them these are better places to drive your boat where there's deeper water and you're not over the eelgrass.
That's fantastic. How long have you been monitoring the eelgrass from the sky?
Using the drone for 3 years now, and we started it when we actually started working with some of our friends from Hakai Institute. So they've taught us this technology, and we've been using it on our own. So it's been a really great partnership working with friends to map eelgrass meadows.
Well, I've said it before and I'll say it again. Teamwork makes for dream work. It's like you've got your own Fish Heads Explorer Club.
We are kind of like our own Fish Heads Club. Yeah, call us the Eelgrass Club.
Now that's a club I'd like to be a part of. Okay, team, you can help out the Eelgrass Club too by making sure you let the captain of the boat you're in know just how important it is to respect those markers, stay out of the eelgrass meadow, and make sure you don't drop an anchor in the nursery.